guest of today, General Yash Mor, is there with us. He's there on the screen. And it's always a pleasure to see sir with so much positivity. So as I introduce you, you will come to know what all sir has achieved in his life. Starting with a cadet at military school, Bangalore. Sir comes from a defense background. He passed out of Indian Military Academy in 1985, commissioned in a very prestigious regiment, the First Guards. He was also mechanized now. And after that, he has been with the battalion. He also cleared his staff college and he also went for a UN mission as a young officer. He also was awarded by Sena Medal, which is a gallantry award, and also commendation by the then Chief of the Army Staff. He has commanded his battalion, First Guards, and after that, Independent Armored Brigade. And he's also been a GOC of a Siberia. Sir is on his academic side. He's an MSc in Defense and Strategic Studies, and he's presently pursuing his PhD. But more than that, on all the things, he's a fitness freak. It gives me really, a lot of jealousy, I would use the word, when I see sir cycling 50 kilometers on a Sunday. And let me tell you, any army officer, the Sunday is the only time you get a little bit to yourself. And that day, he and I've seen sometimes his wife also, both of them, along with motivating other officers of their, who are there to go on a cycling trip. And that speaks volume of his endeavor to stay fit at his age and his service and his motivation. Coming to the next part of sir's personality, down to earth, simple person who can be approached. He loves to talk to students. He loves to encourage people to join the defense forces. Like me, like sir, we are both second generation officers. Both our parents have been in the not a very senior rank in the armed forces, but yet sir has arisen to be a general, which is quite a coveted position, a very, very senior position in the armed forces. Today sir is going to talk on two things. Basically, he is going to talk on his journey from a cadet to a general officer, and secondly, he is going to give you some tips about how you can do well in this attempt to choose this defense force as a career. Sir, it's my pleasure once again, General Yash Mor sir, that you have accepted our invitation to speak to our students. And there are, in fact, a lot of them who are not yet our students, who are just aspirants. They have also joined to listen to you. So over to you now, sir, for your golden words and words of wisdom for them.
Thank you. Thank you so much. It's always such a pleasure to use technology to reach out to young people all across the country. And yesterday we had a session for serving soldiers within my own core zone, and yesterday was Teachers Day. I said there can't be a better day to mentor young people. And today again, it's a Sunday, we have just gone over the Teachers Day, and today happens to be my wife's birthday. So I took her for a 40 kilometer cycle ride this morning. and we unveiled our new jersey today of the club, cycling club, and here I am to share my thoughts with you. So there can't be anything more inspiring, motivating for me also to see you all and your initiative, the way you talk to the students. And it's our endeavor to give back to the society. This is a social service to change the thinking of people and mentor them into joining the armed forces. That is the best. Even if they don't join the armed forces, wherever they go, they must carry these lessons with them and be good citizens of this great country. So with that as the opening remarks, you heard about me. Nothing much. There are many people like me in the army who achieved maybe more than this. But the aim of sharing these thoughts is anything is possible. Don't be hesitant. Don't think you are born in a particular place. आपको opportunity नहीं मिली है, आप कहाँ पढ़ रहे हो, आपको ये मिलता तो आप पता नहीं क्या कर देते. Anything can be possible by sheer hard work and daunting spirit. You need a spirit to do things. So I'll just share in first 10-15 minutes. I'll share my a journey from a cadet in military school to being where I am today, and then few things which I have picked up over a period of time. I can say these are nuggets or tips on leadership, which all of you can do. You don't have to read any book. You can practice this on daily basis and you can see your personality improving. In 1 month, you can see the change in you. And you'll be a much better person. And that will prepare you much better for, you know, service selection board to face the interview if you follow these simple guidelines.
Sir, just a minute. Sir, your voice is slightly breaking. Okay. So, is the mic, are you on the laptop or mobile, sir?
No, I am on the mobile.
Sir, just...
No, how is it?
I
hope it's okay now.
Yeah, this is better. Yes, thank you, sir. Please carry.
So, we'll do initially, I wish to tell you that I belong to a village and there is a girl from my village who's, I can see her, she's online. I sent her, this thing yesterday that you must come. She's a very good aspirant for SSB. And there are many other people who have their roots in village. Most of us, our roots are in the village. And I was born in a soldier's family, a soldier farmer family. Most of them were in our parent generation, either they were farming or they were soldiers in the army. But some of them had great vision. They wanted their children to do well. And that is how this journey began with this thought in my father's mind that I should make an officer out of this young boy. And he prepared me for joining the military school. You know, there are 5 schools and these schools are simply one of the best schools in the country. So I joined Bangalore Military School in 1978, 13 July 1978, as a 10-year-old boy. School is a little tough initially. It's a cadet college. So it took some time adjusting and somehow, initial years of the school, I just didn't like any studies at all. I was, and especially I hated maths and I didn't know how to get over it. It took me some time to get over it. But meanwhile, what happened was I developed immense love for books. In fact, yesterday on Teacher's Day, my tribute was to our school librarian, who is an 80-year-old lady today. And I owe whatever education I got, and not so much from my teachers who taught me maths, physics, science and social studies, but from this great lady who was our library in charge, who would lend us books with a lot of love and affection. And never, even if you are late or something, she was, always nice. That probably, the love for books actually changed my life. Love for books combined with, I always say, sports ground. I was passionately into sports from a very young age. So whatever spare time was available, either it was playing a game or it was in the library. And those days when, newspapers were very rare, I remember as an 11, 12-year-old student, I would get some time to get hold of Deccan Herald or Indian Express or Times of India from the school library. And Sunday morning, when other students were probably relaxing, I would be standing outside the library waiting for the newspaper wala, because I used to slip the newspapers below the library. So with a couple of my friends, I would be outside waiting so that we can get hold of the newspaper. And only thing we read in the newspaper was sports news. In 70s, when India won the World Cup in 1975, or we won the hockey gold in 1980 Olympics, or many of our sportsmen doing well, Prakash Padukone in badminton, or Ramnath Krishnan, Amrit Raj brothers in tennis, everything was on our fingertips. We knew so much about sports and the history of whatever. Then of course, interest into other events also started. That I thought was the base, books and reading newspapers on having a great database of general knowledge, which though even if you are late, you can start even today. You've got to, that gives you confidence, that will give you self-esteem. If you are well read, if you know how events have unfolded, if you can make a short analysis of that and speak to anyone balancing, that will change your life. So school was basically between, and then I found that we were having a lot of debate competitions, declamation competitions, and cultural activities in school, and children were very shy. And since I came from village, I was very, very shy. So somehow I got an opportunity to do a small role in a play where I just have to say one line I had, but that gave me confidence. I started taking part in debate competitions initially, and one had to mug up the script, and they used to take 8 to 10 children, and they selected only the top 2 to represent the house. So I just used to mug up my script and prepared myself, and I think in 6th or 7th I got selected for my house. I got a 3rd or 4th prize in that competition. That changed my life again. From a shy village lad, I started getting onto the school stage, and after that I never looked back. Right from my school, my college, in the university, in the army, I've taken thousands and thousands of lectures on different topics. But the beginning was in the school, and beginning was from ability to mug up those 2 pages, 2.5 pages was what we used to get 2 minutes to speak in debate. Initially it was all Hindi because we are from North India, but my school was absolutely English oriented. So English speaking was also an issue, which I know many of you have this issue. This again, by practice, by listening to people, by reading newspaper, by reading magazine, books, talking to people, pehle tutti frutti mein shuru karo, with simple words, very, very simple words. And then of course it increases. And that is how you build your confidence. So by the time I graduated from my school in 12th standard, I was quite a prolific debater and quite a prolific actor. And I had my, I was an athlete. We could box anybody out of the ring, and basketball and football and cricket and hockey, and we are all absolutely jack of all trades. And that helped me in the, later part. So joined IMA after, graduation, not very good in studies. So I had to really work hard towards my SSB. I knew that one question I will get stumped in SSB is yes, you have so many other abilities, but why haven't you done well in academics? So I was so much prepared for this answer I knew this will be asked of me. So I had to build my other side so strong, that is the academics and the general knowledge, the sports and the passion for life, that the academic part had to be taken care of. Of course, I cleared as lucky, in fact, to clear in my first chance, joined the academy. And from the academy, when I came into the unit, I joined one of the oldest infantry battalions of the Indian Army. And initial period was very tough going, because we had people from all over, and the officers I found were very, very efficient. They were absolutely stunning people. And they thought people like me from village, they are not very polished, and we didn't know much about English music, we didn't know much about many other facets of what tunes the bands are playing and things like that. But I was able to establish myself based on my strength of sports, physical fitness, and ability to speak, ability to communicate and write. So that helped, and it helps in the army. You need leaders who can speak and leaders who can write. Written part is also equally important, not so now for selection of SSB. In SSB too, you need to write, but later on, ability to put your thoughts on paper, writing a paragraph or 2 paragraphs, is very, very important. That I'm sure as you go along you will learn. And then within the army, it was sheer hard work, lot of hard work. Nothing comes easy in the defense forces. You are aware we have a very, very big base pyramid, and very few people then climb the top of the pyramid. It's very tough going. So at every stage, so the hard work doesn't end with just getting commissioned. A lot of people think now it's done, we have become officers, and very, very bright people just fade away because they don't put in the required hard work at crucial stage in life. So somehow I had some great mentors in my unit, great seniors who guided me at very crucial stages in my life, and I continued to work hard, without taking a break. And therefore, whether it was courses, whether it was operational area, I served in Punjab when the insurgency was at its peak. Punjab was burning, and I was involved in fighting this insurgency in very, very remote areas of Tarantaran district. clearing staff college is a challenge. 1:5 is the ratio of selection. So somehow, because of long preparation, I was able to clear my first chance. Then I had a chance to do second staff college. I represented India to do a staff college in Bangladesh, where I was pitted against the Pakistanis, the Chinese officers, and then of course the entire world is represented there. And you are representing your country, so your performance every day you are being judged. So again, I thought I will relax in Dhaka. It's a beautiful city with my family, but I had to put in 8 to 10 hours of work every day to prepare myself. And that really helped, because not only did I get the best dissertation, I put India's flag right on top, absolutely in every field. People still remember, that there was an officer from Indian Army and these were his attributes. But learned everything here on field. Then, I did get to serve in Kashmir. And again, very difficult times, 2001 to 2003, in South Kashmir, in Anantnag. And there, we almost finished, broke the back of Lashkar-e-Toyba and Huzbul Mujahideen and Jaish-e-Mohammed. We did such fantastic work there, I can't tell you. Not only eliminating militants, but also getting people on our side. Total love, affection and regard for our citizens, Kashmiris, and that was a very, very challenging time. It required me to come out of my best in that phase of life. And then after that, of course, things become easy once you command a unit. But my challenge was always to push in more and more soldiers to ACC, more and more people to SCO Commission. And I'm very happy today that at least 5 to 6 officers, majors and lieutenant colonel were children of my JCOs whom I coached or I mentored or gave them this idea. There are 10 to 15 ORs who have even retired now. And now they are, chairman of soldier board or secretary of soldier board in various districts in Haryana, in Himachal and all, who are soldiers in my unit. Today they are sitting in great positions, because they got commissioned and they cultivated this habit of working hard. So this is how it continues to go. And that is why today I'm sitting in front of you, taking out my time on a Sunday morning after a very long ride to share these thoughts with you. Because with hard work, with dedication, with sincerity, you have to be very sincere. I think the USP of all of us, because I can see you all, is sincerity. Ultimate sincerity in what you do, total commitment, and that has to come from mind and heart both. So put everything into it and you will see your rewards coming. So there is no actually a mantra for success. There is no formula. You have to find your own formula. You have to find your own strengths. So work on your strengths and see where your weaknesses lie, improve on your weaknesses. Everybody has weaknesses, severe weaknesses. But by training, by educating yourself, by motivation, you can do it. And I think in one of the last times I told some of the cadets or the candidates who are preparing for SSB, is find a leader around you. Find an inspiring person around you. Don't have to read any books. Just around you will find. In your atmosphere, in your family, in your college, school, or you will find somebody who is a leader. And try and imbibe those qualities from them. Talk to them. See how they behave. How they talk to people. What is their personality. So leadership can be imbibed or copied or taken from people around you. That's been my little formula. And with that, you got to be very, very positive person. Positivity also can be cultivated. In fact, I can tell you even luck can be cultivated. Luckily, you don't need lines on your hands or hair, which is kismat mein nahi tha, nahi ye to hona tha. I just don't believe in all this. Even luck can be driven by you. Everything can be driven by you if you have the willpower and you have the dedication. So be a positive person, be a balanced person. I keep speaking about being balanced. Don't be rigid. Rigidity is harmful. It will make you sick if you are rigid. Be flexible. Avoid education from social media. There's too much. Please avoid WhatsApp University. It is dangerous. It uses it as a communication tool, but don't learn from it, because there are too many half-truths, big truths and propaganda that is floating around, which is really very, very dangerous. Be a good listener. And at your age, be a good follower first, to be a good leader later on. Be a good follower. Follow people whom you admire. And with this, always I keep saying, because you want to be officers in army, none of us want to be professors or scientists or technocrats. So they may need different qualities. But for you and me, we have to balance mind and body. We have to balance mind, body and soul. How do you do it? By being physically fit. That is one part. That is your balancing your body. Eating less. I see people, young people, obese, looking older, double chin, tummy coming out. How can you have nature has given us such wonderful body structure, all of us. We are born so beautifully. And then by, poor eating habits, I don't know what we make of this wonderful body. So love your body. Love yourself. For that, you have to work hard. You have to get up whenever. Or if you can't get up early, please do it in the afternoon. Do it at night, but find time. And for your soul, for your mind. Your mind also, you have to keep, feeding it good information. You know, keep feeding. So reading, talking to good people, reading about great saints like Kabir and Nanak and Bhule Shah and Mirabai. This country is blessed, I'm telling you. This country is blessed. Read about Vivekananda. Read about Dhanan Saraswati. And read across the board. You'll realize why are people fighting today on caste and sectarian and religious basis. I really can't understand. Because none of them ever spoke of religion. They're great people, great saints India has produced. Read, learn about them. Even today you can follow some of them. The modern age gurus are very good. So feed your mind with something positive and your body. Be always flexible in your approach. Change your views. Last time also said, please learn, unlearn, relearn, delete, add, delete. Whatever are your thought process today, ki aise hota hai, ye aise hota hai, ye aisa hai. Kuch din ke usko delete kar do. And add. We have a limited space in our mind. And don't fill the space with, dislikes or hatred for a community or religion and all. You are wasting your mind space. So, this habit of being flexible, ki yaar ye badi achhi baat hai. ये तो बहुत अच्छी बात कही उन्होंने. ये तो आई एम टेलिंग यू, आई रिमेंबर इवन 30 इयर्स, 35 इयर्स, 40 इयर्स बैक समबडी सेड समथिंग एंड इट हैज स्टक इन माय माइंड कि यार ये बात बहुत अच्छी, ऐसे ही करना. सो दिस अगेन यू कैन ट्रेन योरसेल्फ, बिकॉज माइंड इज इन योर हैंड्स. माइंड एंड बॉडी आर बोथ इन योर हैंड्स. सो वर्क ऑन बोथ. यू गॉट टू बी स्मार्ट. स्मार्ट मीन्स एंड स्मार्ट पीपल देन सेल्फ एस्टीम ऑटोमेटिकली वेयर. So do that. Then recognize the difference between religion and spirituality. I speak a lot on this because it's my life's mission to take people away from organized religion. It is dangerous. Not at your age. Certainly, time aayega 70 saal ke baad dekh lena kya karna. Otherwise, stay totally away from it. Because it is teaching you many other places that this is good, but this is certainly not good, which I don't like. So there are bits and pieces of good and bad in everything. So best is to keep it on a side. You are a student now. Your focus is to be, and in army we are looking for such people. We are looking for people who are flexible, who are balanced, who respect everyone of all caste communities and all that. So cultivate that from the beginning. Then, but to do all this, you need to set goals. So goal setting is very, very important. And this again can be trained. And set small, small goals. I keep telling you, set a goal for a month. Ki ek mahine mein maine 3 kilo wazan kam karna, usko likh do apne table ke upar. Maine 6 mahine mein ye karna hai. Maine 2 mahine mein ye 4 kitabein padhni hai. मैंने ये प्रिपेयर करना है. मैंने पब्लिक स्पीकिंग में 3 मिनट्स का अपना लेक्चरेट की प्रैक्टिस अगले 2 महीने में परफेक्ट होना है. सो set small goals. Don't look long term, but only for few things, short term, and then keep moving from one goal to another. But best is write them down. You must write it, Hindi, English, whatever, and put it on your table or your computer or your book or somewhere. Stick it. Let people laugh. Arey kya likh diya yaar? Bolo koi baat nahi aise. They not understand. But when they see you, because that has to be seen by you day in and day out. So this again is you can easily do it. And you know, at young age, with social media today, internet availability, this thing of you know, so many platforms are catching your attention. So you have to, you know, juggle, see what is urgent and what is important. Too many times we are wasting thinking this is urgent, but it's not important. So prioritize. Start now prioritizing in your mind कि मेरे लिए ये जरूरी है, मैंने करना है. Even if there's pressure for family, just ignore them. In long run, they'll be happy if you become an officer. I'm telling you, when I was preparing for my staff college in the year 1995, and a lot of people got upset because I stopped attending birthday parties, marriage anniversaries, and things like that. And they said, "Yeah, you didn't come." I said, "Oh, sorry, I had to work here." So, but I knew the same people very happy. So for about 7-8 months, I just didn't attend any of this thing. So some of them, "Yeah, you didn't come to my house. Yeah, you got invited." I said, "Arey sir, koi nahi. Ye aise karke." Because this mission was more important to clear. So ऐसी चीज में कोई फैमिली का प्रेशर, किसी रिलेशनशिप का प्रेशर बीच में नहीं आना चाहिए. जस्ट टेल देम थैंक यू. डोंट बी रूड, बट टेल देम थैंक यू. बी फोकस्ड. सो रियलाइज व्हाट इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू एंड डोंट वेस्ट टाइम. टाइम इज ऑफ एसेंस. डिवाइड योर टाइम इनटू सेगमेंट्स एंड फ्यू थिंग्स यू डू एवरी डे. दैट इज फिटनेस. आई सी टुडे, आई एम सो हैप्पी टू सी गर्ल्स रनिंग, गर्ल्स ऑन साइकिल्स, and jogging, and the, especially the girls are doing fabulously well. I'm so proud to see the girls, really. It's making of a new India. The boys need to catch up now. Too many distractions, I think you have. So you need to catch up. Now, few things I thought I'll, you know, share about for SSB. What I feel, I'm not a coach like your director. I have never been a GT or president, but my own experiences is, firstly, be original. They are looking for original products. In trying to answer or prepare ourselves, and you know, I like this, what he said, there's no coaching, there can only be guidance and mentoring. So uske chakkar mein I see, when I meet candidates who are going to go for SSB, they come to me and meet, their answers are very artificial. So somewhere in trying to please somebody, आप अपनी जो originality है वो खो देते हो. I keep telling you, जाओ बढ़िया तैयारी करके जाओ, but be what you are, speak what you feel is right. If they want you, they'll take you. If they don't take you, say thank you very much. Say thank you very much. I have got a lot of other options. Options will start generating on their own, but be original. It will help you always in SSB. Then I've seen, I think the director can correct me, be bold. Be bold and be innovative in your answer. Don't worry, don't hesitate. I have at least, whenever I gave answers in many interviews that I faced to go abroad or this thing, I never bothered ki nahi select karo, tumhari marzi hai, it is your loss. But I will, what I feel is right. I will not tell you what I perceive ki aapko suna, aap sunna chahte ho. I will tell you what I feel is right. So be innovative, be bold, don't be timid. Lot of you, because you feel hesitation, bolna, thodi timidity and meekness aati hai. Why should you be meek in front of anyone? No. So this also you can cultivate and train by, you know, continuously practicing your communication skills, or you know, your whatever the tests are. Prepare well. Prepare, put in a lot of hard work. But when you go for the exam, be calm. This has been my formula. I've been a sportsman. I played, you know, at certain level, games, and I realized that too many people, don't practice, and then you are, trying to find some material for you. So work hard and then be calm. Then be totally focused and prepare well. So if you are focused and you prepare well, then you can certainly answer in a manner you want. So I thought these are few small little tips I can give you on SSB and in general in life. I hope they are useful. I can take on any questions if you have.
Thank you very much, sir. I as always today I have also made my notes, and I'm sure a lot of students who are listening, I'm sure they have made these notes. And friends, if you have not made notes, things will evaporate from your mind. For that, sir has permitted us. We will be putting this interview, this session of sir, on the YouTube. I would recommend all of you, if you have not made your notes, you can go through it on the YouTube again slowly. Note down the carry home point which you should implement in your life. For example, deciding your short term goals, next 15 days goal, 2 months goal, 3 months goal, working on your physical fitness, right? Focus, right? Small goals, choose a leader around you. So these are some of the things which sir has told, which need introspection, which need you to think about it. Sir, there are about 5-6 questions, and I will start inviting the students who have written the questions. First, I'll be inviting Nidhi Manglik. She's asking about the TA. And okay, you can put on your video. Baki sa videos apna off karo, Dushyant Patel and all. I can see your videos on. Please keep your videos off, even if you're outside. Yeah, Nidhi, you can please ask a question.
Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, director, sir. I'm Nidhi this side.
Hi, Nidhi.
Hi, sir. It's a pleasure listening to you and listening on the cycling and workout thing. I am really floored with it, sir. It's a real good motivation this morning. My question is, sir, that I would be appearing for TA, and I would be competing with people, with candidates who are almost 10 years younger to me. So what is that one belief that I should carry with me and cultivate in me, sir? I should cultivate in me and should carry with me to my interview desk, sir.
I think, Nidhi, you are there. The way you asked the question, I think you're already there. you don't have to do anything extra. Your confidence and your ability in yourself and your passion, I think that will just be yourself. And don't worry about age is only in the mind. 2 days back I was in Udaipur, and I was cycling with a youngster who was a captain, who was at least about 30 years my junior, and he could catch up with me. He said, sir, I just couldn't catch up. Manika, better I'll take you some training. You're fitter, you're young, younger legs. But I'll take you some training. And so I said, you can't catch up. 1 month cycle chalaoge, tab you'll be able to ride with me. Don't worry about age. Right. I think you are there. Nothing can stop you.
Thank you so much, sir. This is so much positive and motivating. It is really nice, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, yes. Sir, the next question is being asked by Prashant Sharma. Prashant, can you please come online and ask a question to sir?
Good afternoon, sir.
Hi, Prashant.
Sir, it is said that every great goal, it should scare you a bit and excite you a bit more. So, sir, may you share one such an inspiring experience where you were excited and scared at both times?
Yeah, this is just a few days back, actually, but what I can straightway think of. 15th August, less than a month back, and somehow I had started thinking on my own mind. I'm a new cyclist, I'm not a very professional, and maximum I had done was 50 kilometers. And mere mind mein aaya, this is 74th Independence Day of the country, main kya karu is din? And lockdown hai, corona ka chakkar hai. So I decided in my mind, can I do 74 kilometers? So quietly I told my wife two three days back, yaar maine na main socha se ki kehti tu pagal hai, apni umar dekh kaise jayega, and don't ever think, why do you think of such things? एक दिन मैंने कहा नहीं नहीं मैंने करना है एंड आई एंड मेंटली आई स्टार्टेड प्रिपेयरिंग सो आई वाज स्केयर्ड इफ आई हैव टोल्ड हर एंड आई यू नो आई हैव थॉट ऑफ कि मैंने करना है 74 किलोमीटर्स पता नहीं होगा या नहीं होगा यार बट इट वाज एक्साइटिंग एज वेल सो आई जस्ट डोंट यू नो दैट डे आई गॉट अप मच अर्लियर आई डिडंट इवन बिफोर माय अलार्म वेंट ऑन आई वाज अप mentally I was prepared and I did 76 kilometers and I prepared to do another 24 to complete a century till you know I decided nahi yaar bahut ho gaya humne apna target achieve kar liya so it was exciting and scaring both ki nahi hoga to yaar I will in my own eyes and you know I told my wife and you know my staff knows ki I am planning 74 kilometers ride aur nahi hoga to kya hoga So it was both exciting and scary also. But do it. Risk lena bada zaruri hai. I didn't touch this part. I'm telling you, I'm a big risk taker.
Sir, in fact, yes, sir. Prashant has just cracked his SSB from Air Force Board Dehradun. Just I think 2 weeks back, he was one of our online students. I have not yet met him. He is yet to come and take the tie, which we give as a prize, the MR's tie. And totally online preparation, and he's cracked SSB in his, I think, first attempt, and now he's looking forward to joining us. But yes, Prashant, you need to put exercise the way sir does it. You need to lose some weight, and that's the best way sir has taught you. You come from Ghaziabad, and you come to Greater Noida on cycle. Okay.
Yeah. You do that.
To take the tie, right? That'll be a real spirit of this webinar if you come from there on cycle to take the tie from Hemas. Okay, next question. I am inviting Prajwal Thakur. He's a service candidate. Sir. Okay, Prajwal.
Yeah.
Prajwal, come in.
Yeah.
Video. Bada video on kar.
Yeah, Jayant.
I can't hear you.
Yes.
Yeah, Jayant.
हाँ, जोर से बोलो.
हाँ. Yeah, Jayant sir, I'm Prajwal Thakur sir. Currently, I'm serving in army and I'm a soldier. So I just want to ask, like you know, like every of like your soldier life is full of you know work. So we have a set schedule for our day. So what kind of activities I need to do, and how can I make myself innovative, more innovative?
So basically, I just couldn't hear you. I don't know.
Basically, he's asking that being a soldier and the day-to-day activities in the unit. How does he find time, and then on what all things he should focus on?
I know something wrong with the audio here. Something wrong with the audio. Can you hear me?
Yes, yeah. I can hear you. I can hear you, sir.
So maybe there was a call coming in between, and I lost the sound. Is sound is not very clear, but maybe you can. I just couldn't make out. Prajwal, you ask again if you can.
Yes sir, I'm saying I'm a soldier in army right now, so I'm like we have a set schedule for our day, so I just want to know like what kind what you want to recommend me, like what kind of activities I need to do more and more in order to make myself more innovative here.
Again, some issue of sound. I don't know if you can type it.
Sir, can you hear me, sir?
Maybe I'll get my headphones.
सर आई रिक्वेस्ट आप एक बार लॉग ऑफ करके लॉग इन कर लो सर लॉग ऑफ लॉग इन करने से समटाइम्स इट बिकम्स एब्सोल्युटली क्लियर सर
या या आई जस्ट
या जस्ट लॉग ऑफ एंड लॉग इन सर और प्रज्वल जस्ट अ मिनट आई कुड हियर यू क्लियरली बट देयर इज सम इशू विद सर या बट अदरवाइज डोंट वरी आई विल आंसर योर क्वेश्चन बिकॉज यू नो आई एम इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ मेंटरिंग सोल्जर्स यंग सोल्जर्स लाइक यू ऑल द टाइम And the last ACC 121, 8 of our soldiers cracked SSB.
I'm well aware of it, sir. Yes.
Yeah. So I'll tell you how to manage time. You know, I'll tell you just let sir come in. After that, I'm going to invite Jyoti, and I'm going to invite.
I'm back. I think.
Right, sir. Right. Sir. Can you hear, sir? Now clearly, sir.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Yeah. I'm back. Now I
basically
can hear you.
Yeah, Prajwal basically is asking, sir. He's a soldier. He's saying how to find time and what all things to focus on, because every day they are engaged in different activities at unit level. We are aware, sir, that as young soldiers they are always bound with some duties.
I know, Prajwal. Where are you posted and which unit?
Sir, currently I'm in 19 Dogra. It is posted in West Bengal right now. It is Binnagudi and you can't hear.
Okay, okay. See, Prajwal, unit ki lies yaar main samajh sakta hoon. And ye challenge hai, kafi busy morning se evening. I think what you have done is, especially when you are on static duty, and there are long static duties in the army. You go on a guard somewhere or you're in QRT. उसमें ना मैं देखता हूँ यार कई को ड्राइवर हैं क्या 5-6-7 आवर्स जस्ट सिटिंग आइडल एंड यू नो लॉट ऑफ टाइम सो यू मस्ट कैरी योर फोन यू मस्ट कैरी योर बुक कैरी योर डायरी योर पेन एंड यूज दैट टाइम मेनी ऑफ द थिंग्स आई लर्न एज अ यंग ऑफिसर इन इन पुंछ रजौरी एंड दीज प्लेसेस was I would sit on a post or go long patrolling. I always carried my BBC ka world receiver radio radio. So I was listening to news wherever I was. I always carried a diary and a pen and any magazine. मैं बता रहा हूँ हमें तो नई magazine देखने को नहीं मिलती थी तो कुछ 6 महीने पुरानी time की magazine मिल गई कोई न्यूज भी 1 साल पुराना न्यूज वीक की magazine मिल गई तो उसको उठाया अपने झोले में डाल लिया और कहीं बैठ के पढ़ रहे हैं यार दुनिया की कोई बात है पता नहीं इतनी साल पुरानी 6 महीने पुरानी पुराना न्यूज़पेपर 3 दिन पुराना आता था हमें हफ्ते के बाद मिलता था उसको उठाया रोल किया अपने साथ ले गए जहां मौका मिला उसको पढ़ना शुरू कर दिया सो आई थिंक वेर एवर यू आर ऑन सच ड्यूटी स्टैटिक ड्यूटीज एंड यू टेल यूर CHM एंड ऑल कि यार मेरे को उस्ताद ऐसी जगह लगा दो यार जहां मैं अपना थोड़ा पढ़ाई पढ़ू उनको खुश रखो सो दैट दे एनकरेज यू एंड यू आर एबल टू फाइंड टाइम
Yeah, definitely, sir.
Thank you, sir, for suggesting him. Prajwal, what sir has suggested, please incorporate that in your daily routine. And also to add to that, I would, sir, I also say that 90 days leave is given to you by the Government of India. ACC candidate comment tells me, sir, मेरे को CO time नहीं दिया तो मैं उसे पूछा तू 90 दिन क्या किया था जो तेरा time था.
That is
something which please plan your leave. What sir is saying, the way he prepared for those staff quality later on also, those 90 days are your leave. Please reply that. Next question, Jyoti. Jyoti, please come on. Jyoti K.
Sir, actually I am Midun. I designated my mother's name.
Okay. Okay. Midun. Okay, Midun. Then
okay.
Yeah,
sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Hello, Mithun, haan bolo.
Sir, it's very auspicious moment to see you in screen again, sir. So, actually, I'm an MA student. I'm student of Colonel MP, sir. So, my question is, sir, we are having sort of lot of strength and weakness. So, how to find our strength and weakness? And I am, it's right now situation, I'm slightly quite conflict about to how to find it in very well-being manner, sir. So, I'm an ACC aspirant. I'm looking for my ACC 122. I cleared my written examination.
Very good. You will surely clear. The very fact you are looking at strength and weakness. Dekho, what I feel now, Mithun, you should know what you are. And some time you get for contemplating, sit quietly, and you know where your strength and weakness are. इसको हम अपने आप को झूठ नहीं बोल सकते हैं दूसरों को बोल सकते हैं So carry out your inner introspection, अपने अंदर झांको और देखो यार कि मेरे में स्ट्रेंथ क्या और मेरी वीकनेस क्या है एंड हाउ डू यू नाउ यूज योर स्ट्रेंथ एज ए टूल इधर यू हाइड योर वीकनेस और यू इम्प्रूव अपॉन इट कई तो कुछ वीकनेस ऐसी होती है इट्स बेटर टू हाइड देम बिकॉज देयर इज नो टाइम टू वर्क ऑन इट दे विल टेक अ लॉन्ग टाइम यू नो दीज आर फ्रॉम द एनवायरमेंट वेयर एवर वन हैज ऑल ह्यूमंस आर यू नो from are different so I think you look inwards do some contemplation self-contemplation self-introspection actually self-introspection the right word and you write it down
yes sir
jahan tak mujhe lagta hai ki jahan tak logo ki your confidence english speaking se so put on your camera take up topics you tell your sister brother somebody or mujhe topic do and I'll prepare and start writing down start recording your own answers or your lectures and listen to them.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir. SSB में यही चीजें हैं group discussion में कई बार क्या somebody will just steal the thunder आपने वो बोलना था कोई और बोल दे आप तुम repeat करोगे तो कहीं जा रहे तो उसी को repeat कर रहा है क्या फायदा? So at that stage you need to
change your mind quickly and speak about something which you are otherwise not convinced.
Yes, sir.
So this art you have to develop, you know, slowly. You are a young man, I'm sure you can certainly identify your strengths and weaknesses, but exploit your strengths and if possible hide your weaknesses or improve upon them. That I think is the practical way to do.
Yes, sir, fine.
Right. Thank you, sir. And now I think we'll go to the last question. This is Bobby Vora.
Mm-hmm.
Bobby Vora, are you there? Bobby Vora, is it there or you left the meeting? Okay, Bobby Vora, are you there? He's not there. Shishir Mishra. Shishir Mishra. Yeah.
Shishir Mishra.
Shishir Mishra. Bobby, yes, sir. Please ask a question.
Sir, very good afternoon, sir. Sir, I wanted to ask, I have been a student of AMR's online course and I'm supposed to appear in on 1st of October in AFSB Gandhinagar. Sir, my question is, how to be focused more on the process rather than getting carried away by the expectation of result, like it always comes to mind what will happen if the result goes my way and not the other way around. So it gets affected by that, and I think my test performances are getting affected due to this.
No, I in fact, if you heard me clearly somewhere in the end when I was talking about preparing for SSB, this is the challenge, and a lot of good candidates are unable to perform there because of this pressure of expectations. And we put too much onto ourselves. That's why I said be original, be innovative, be bold. Don't be timid. Prepare yourself. And if your gut feeling enough, I believe a lot on gut feeling. People who, if you read this amazing book, Blink, you must read this book, Blink. It'll tell you how in a blink of a second, you arrive at conclusions and, you know, they generally turn out true. They generally turn out true. So, isliye, ye bhi aap, with your practice, don't put pressure on yourself. That's what I said. Go to SSB thinking in not the end of life. What so what if I don't get selected?
Yes.
This pressure of being selected and kya hoga na, this somehow it is impinging on your negative impact on your personality. And people are unable to. I'm sure director can tell you who's been a assessing officer. This I think. Especially in
the
ACC candidate, this is a major problem.
Sir, one thing I would like to share with you, one very interesting thing from my life, sir. I was in my college final year at Bombay, St. Xavier's College, and we had this campus placements coming in. And this 5-star hotel team had come and they wanted to pick up management trainees. So about 5 rounds, and I finally, out of 5 rounds, I was selected in the last 5. So in the last 5 rounds, it was the vice president of that Oberoi International. And he was, I think, a retired officer of army, brigadier or something. So he asked me, so what if we don't take you? So I said, sir, why? What if you don't get selected here? What will you do? I said, sir, I've done so well. There is no way that you will not select me. Mm. He said, no, just suppose. I said, sir, I can't even suppose because each and every test which you have put me through, I've done the best and I've done very well.
Mm.
He thought for a minute. He says, no, but there could be some reason that we don't take you. Then what will you do? I said, sir, if you don't take me, I've already cleared the CDS return. I will join IMA after 2 months. And finally, sir, they took me. Now, my SSB was yet to come. After 1 month, my SSB came and I went to SSB. And that IO asked me the same question. So, if you don't clear the SSB, what will you do? I said, sir, firstly, I've done very well. I must clear. He says, no, if you don't clear. I said, sir, I'll join Oberoi International because I've already cleared. So, I cleared both places, sir.
So you have to be bold.
Yeah, you have to be bold. And you can't show, okay, sir, please, sir, mar gaya, sir, mereko le lo, sir. You have to show, yeah, I've got options. That's what I feel, sir. I tell them also, please have options. Don't go there with a pleading, okay, sir, mera ye last chance, sir, aap nahi loge, toh bas meri jindagi khatam ho jayegi. Not like that, sir.
Chalo, okay. We'll take the last question.
Right. Okay, then. Okay, any more questions? Right, sir. I think we have finished with all the relevant questions, sir. And now the last part, I would like to extend a Big thank you to you, sir. And what will be your last message to these aspirants, sir? Last message to these aspirants.
Last message is, what should I say? Just be bold. This country, there are too many opportunities now. Don't put too much of pressure on yourself. Don't put too much of pressure on yourself. But inside, work hard. But outside, stay calm. Don't put pressure on yourself. And be bindas. Be bold. I think you'll carry the day if you're bold.
So thank you so much, sir. With this, a lot of thanks to you once again to have come for this special webinar. And it's always a treat to interact with you, sir. And I'm looking forward to physically meeting you sometimes.
Yes, thank you.
You get more inspired with that live session sometime if you are here.
Thank you
very much, sir.
And thank you very much. All the best to you all. Thanks. All the best, Jayin. All the best. Yes. Thank you.
Okay, friends, so that was our chief guest of the day, General Yash Mohr. And let me tell you, General Yash Mohr is a serving Major General. He's not retired, is it? Right? He's serving, and it's such a treat to see a serving officer doing so well and motivating people like you so that you can achieve your goal. Okay? And I think the last sentence which he said about boldness, about being bold, is very good. First, but I just add one caveat to it. One caveat is prepare well and then be bold. Prepare well and then be bold. Okay. If you don't prepare well, that boldness will be artificial. It will be shallow boldness. Okay. It will be like a balloon. Choda sa puncher hua, phat jayega, phir khatam ho jayega. So, prepare well for the... in this case your SSB, otherwise you prepare well for whatever test you are going to, and then be bold. And next part which even SSB is looking at very closely, you can put on your videos now. The second aspect which SSB is very, very closely looking at is something is what is called as originality. I try in every way to teach you originality. For example, when you are reading this, you see, before you come for your SSB, most of you are doing this TAT and VAT and from all kind of nonsense sources which are possible in the internet, right? And you will get stereotype ideas. Acha, ye picture aa gaya, toh aisa story likh do, ye aa gaya, toh aisa story. Aapka originality kahan hai? Aapka originality ye dekh rahe ho. Right? So, whatever preparations you are doing, if you're doing from the internet, then if you're seeing these pictures of TAT, just see the pictures, don't see their solutions. Your mind will get colored by if you see their solutions. Then you will not be able to think of anything else but whatever is just there in that. Right? Learn the right way. Now, two more things which sir has told those of you who are appearing for SSB. Two more very important things: physical fitness. Other than the boldness and originality, keep these two things in mind. Right? Physical fitness is a very important part of a soldier's life. So those of you who are aspiring to be soldiers, get out of your house in the morning or in the evening. Get out of your house. Leave your comfort of the bed. Okay. If today I can do obstacles and running, you can imagine how much endeavor it requires at 52 years of age. Right. So there was a time, once I went to my relative in Ranchi. So I was desperately looking. Ranchi was such a crowded city. I was looking, bhagun kahan? Till about 2 years back, I used to run. Even now, though I'm doing more of walking now, but I will start running soon again. So I found a gym nearby and I went. I said, mereko treadmill chahiye. He said, first, main kaha nahi, treadmill 15-20 minute ke liye chahiye, main treadmill pe hi bhagunga. To unhone socha hai, thoda iske daadi ke baal bhi safed hai, old man type lag raha hai, kitna bhag lega? To chota sa gym tha, maybe about 200 square feet area, and there were 3-4 people at the time. So I started on the treadmill. I put the speed 8.8 or 9 and I started off. So generally, if you go to any gym, they are written 15 minute treadmill because they want more people to do this. I kept running. Usko pata nahi tha ye 4G hai. And this is just about 2 years back. I was 50. So I started running. 15 minute ho gaya, 20 ho gaya, 25 ho gaya, 30 ho gaya, 35 ho gaya, 40 ho gaya. Wo aaya beech mein, udhar dekh raha hai, speed dekh raha hai, kitna ho gaya, kitna ho gaya. 5 हो गया, कितना और करोगे? मैंने कहा जब तक हो पाएगा करेंगे, राइट, तेरे को फीस दिया है ना, आई वाज गिविंग सम 200 रुपीस अ डे और समथिंग, फीस दिया है ना, तो कोई वेट भी नहीं कर रहा तो भागने दो मेरे को. उसके बाद वेल आई स्टॉप एट 1 hour एंड आई डन 8.8 किलोमीटर. सो लाइक ही कॉल्ड फ्यू पीपल हु आर देयर इन द जिम, बोला ये देखो तुम लोग मोटे मोटे हैं, पिछले 6 महीने से इधर जिम कर रहे हो, अभी तक तुम्हारा वेट कम नहीं हुआ, इधर देखो ये सर को, ये 8.8 किलोमीटर भाग लिया 1 घंटे में. सो सर आप कैसे करते हो सर, वहां पे देयर आर सम टू लेडीज एंड 2-3 बॉयज राइट, सब वहां पे अपना स्टाइल मारने आ रहे हैं, कोई वहां पे फिजिकल फिटनेस करने नहीं आ रहा जिम में, स्टाइल मारने और स्टाइल दूसरे का देखने आ रहे, कोई फिजिकल फिटनेस करने नहीं आ रहा. और यहाँ पे एक आदमी घोड़े की नाल लगा के भाग रहा है जिम. उसके बाद आई वॉज देयर फॉर अबाउट 15 days एंड आई हैड अ गुड टाइम बिकॉज़ दीस गाइस दे स्टार्ट रिस्पेक्टिंग, दे केम टू नो दैट आई एम आर्मी ऑफिसर, सो देन दे शुड टॉक एंड ऑल दैट. सो व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज गेट आउट ऑफ योर कंफर्ट जोन, एंड दैट इज नॉट फिजिकल फिटनेस, डजंट मीन कि आप कल से सुबह 4 बजे से लेकर 8 बजे तक भागते रहो और आके इतना डेड टायर्ड हो जाओ कि पढ़ भी ना सको. फिजिकल फिटनेस मीन्स divide your time of the day into 4-5 parts, whatever you want to focus on. Physical fitness is just one part of it. Maybe 1 hour, maybe 1.5 hours, maximum 2 hours. Then mental fitness. Read. News, quest for knowledge. The bottom line is quest for knowledge has to be there. When you read a news, there's so many things part of the news. You must look for those things. Those of you who appeared in my entrance, I ask you basic questions sometimes, 8-10 questions I ask you, and then you don't know. Like today I just interviewed him, just 1 month back, such an important neighboring country of ours went through elections, right? And I asked him, what is the name of the newly elected president? It matters to India, but we don't know. And then he says, sir, I read newspaper. Stop reading newspapers. Did you get me? Stop reading newspaper. Start writing it. If you only read, it will evaporate. यहाँ से आज पढ़ा गया, कल नया पढ़ लिया, पिछले दिन का गया न्यूज, यू विल नॉट रिमेंबर. स्टॉप रीडिंग न्यूज पेपर, स्टार्ट राइटिंग इंपॉर्टेंट न्यूज फ्रॉम द न्यूज पेपर, देन इट विल गो समवेयर इन योर माइंड. जब हाथ चलेगा कॉपी के ऊपर. ऑल माई सक्सेसफुल कैंडिडेट्स आई मेड देम राइट. रीडिंग न्यूज इज एट आवर लेवल है आज, जहां अब तो भाई आराम से हमने पढ़ना है, क्या लिखा अच्छा ये, क्या लिखा वो, क्या ये हमारे. आप कॉम्पिटेटिव लाइफ में चल रहे हो. एट योर एज आई वॉज मगिंग अप 193 कंट्रीज, देयर कैपिटल, देयर हेड ऑफ स्टेट्स एंड देयर करेंसीज. यू कुड आस्क मी करेंसी ऑफ बोलीविया, यू कुड आस्क मी करेंसी ऑफ पेरू एट योर एज, एंड आई वुड टेल यू राइट इन 1 मिनट, 1 second. टूडे आई आस्क देम, who is the president of prime minister of England? That also you don't know. I'm talking of South African country, South American countries. And suddenly, last week, one candidate asked in SSB, tell me the countries of South American continent. And center wicket would have tuck. He didn't know a single country. What are you talking of? What is your awareness? And then they'll ask, sir, पता नहीं सर कैसे रिजेक्ट हो गया. दे इंटरव्यू ऑफिसर्स डोंट हैव मच टाइम, दे विल फाइंड आउट विद इन 15-20 मिनट्स वेयर यू स्टैंड. फिनिश्ड. ओके, सो गेट ऑन विद इट, डोंट लीव थिंग्स टू फेट. ओके, एंड थिंग्स कैन बी डन. दोज ऑफ यू फील कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स आर वीक, गेट ऑन विद इट. ओके, I was speaking to somebody yesterday. I gave my own example. If my house till 11th, I could not speak English. And my mother got worried. Now, the best part was my mother also could not speak English. But she has ensured that all my 3 elder siblings went to the convent schools. So, all the 3 elder siblings of mine were in St. Joseph. And that time, these convent schools will not accept a word of Hindi in the school. There's to be fine of 50 paisa if the child is found speaking Hindi. Right, so they were very good, and suddenly I came on. I had not studied in convent school. Father was getting transferred. Right, Rishabh Mahajan, वही तो बता रहा हूँ तेरे को, अभी सुन ले, तू question अभी पूछ रहा है. So my mother one fine day called my 3 elder siblings and gave them an order that this youngster doesn't know, and I was in 11th. She said, this guy I have never seen speaking in English. Now imagine, my mother could not understand English. But she knew these elder ones are speaking English and the younger one is not speaking English. So she gave an order. From tomorrow onwards, none of you will go to speak in Punjabi or Hindi with him. So the environment of the house changed. They said, fine. She said, I made you study in convent schools so that you people do well in society. And here is the fourth son. We are four. He can't speak. In his school, nobody speaks. No, I can't help it. I can't change his school. His father was posted in Srinagar that time, Patan. And my mother and we four were at separated family quarters in Jalandhar. Now, Jalandhar, in school, mein ya to Punjabi bol rahe hai, Hindi bol rahe hai, English ko bol hi nahi ra. And that too, KV, Kendriya Vidyalayas. Right. So the order came in my house and my elder brother sister started speaking. I picked up. They barred me to see Hindi movies. They said, okay, some English serials you will see. You will read the newspaper and tell us the news after reading the newspaper. Right. So this is how I learned. And of course, then I went to my college in Bombay. And in Bombay, of course, one had no choice either to speak English or to stay shut. Keep your mouth shut. Because there's nobody who would understand Hindi or Marathi in St. Xavier's at least. So there, majboori, I had to pick up. And it took me about 6 months. So some base was made at home in class 12th, 11th and 12th with the endeavors of my mother. Then rest of it was in my college. So now those of you are asking me how to improve your communication skills. Input devices and output devices. Your input devices are your ears and eyes. They are the input devices to the brain. How did you learn Hindi? Because your mother spoke Hindi in your ears, no? Or how did you learn Marathi? Because it went through your ears first and you started coming out. This is the output device, mouth and hands. Hands can write and mouth can speak. Input device, ear and eyes. There is a CPU, your brain. Put English in your head, in your eyes and in your ears. It will come, start coming out from here. The problem is you people don't put input. You want a capsule. Abhi wo nikla nahi hai. Capsule. Jo ki English speaking capsule ho jayega. Ya GK speaking capsule ho jayega. Capsule khaya sara GK brain ke andar gaya. Wo se mehnat karna padega. Right. Another example I'll give you. In Allahabad, I was doing my study leave. So there are a lot of college students along in the class. 22 students were there. I was only officer. So I said, okay, I can help you learn. All of you go to do for competition. They just did not learn. So one boy came. I said, yes, sir, I want to learn. I want to speak, sir. I said, what newspaper do you read? He says, Navbharat Times. I said, what serials do you watch? He says, I watch Aaj Tak on TV and I watch all these serials. What language do you speak at home? He says, sir, ghar mein to sab Hindi bolta. So, I said, sara din to tumhare, tum padhte bhi Hindi ho, sunte bhi Hindi ho, to kaise English niklegi muh se tumhare? Right, so that is about this thing. And especially the other part, GK Current Affairs. Please start listening to the news on the TV, start reading newspapers, right? Start doing some additional work of search, right? In fact, kal sab teachers ka mereko do teen vocals bhi bhej diye student ne, thank you so much. Teachers ko sabne kaha, sabse bada teacher to Google hai hamara, right? Google ko kisi ne bouquet nahi bheje, kisi ne thank you Google nahi bola, sara kuch to usse poochte ho, right? So, with that be all, I think we end the session here. It is almost 1 hour plus that we talking. Anybody wants to ask anything to me? Otherwise, we'll log off.
So, I have a question.
Yeah.
So, you just said that we need to write news, not read news.
Right.
So, how do we practice that? How is it?
See, I'm feeding. I'm feeding.
Approach to it.
No, when you have to write the news, see, I'm feeding you the five, six important news every day. I'm doing that on my website. So as of now, with the all newspapers, things and all, people are not buying newspapers. As of now, you can use that. Read those five news, make a gist in your own words in your copy or start a diary, date-wise.
Okay.
Like
okay.
Five news you read, we generally put five or six.
Right.
So write a gist of at least three or four in your own word. This is the news, this is the day. So mostly you will find in that news, there will be some national news, some international news, some military news. We pick up from these three things. Okay. National, right. International, military. So pick up out of these seven also, I would say even if you pick up three per day, three important words, whatever you choose, so that will keep building up with good awareness.
Right,
so,
sir.
Make a separate register and that will help you, get. And after that, next thing you should do is once a week, 1 week is over, then go through the news of 1 week, whatever you have written.
Okay.
Right, go through it, revise it. Then any important ones, underline it, that if somebody asks me any important news of last 1 week, I will give 1, 2, and 3. That's it. So let's say you are adding on average 3 news per day in your diary.
Right.
That makes it 21 news a week.
Right,
now, at the end of the week, you should know which are the 2 or 3 important news in this week.
Right, sir.
Right? So, maybe encircle them or highlight them. Then do the same exercise after 1 month. That means at the end of 1 month, it could be 3 into 30, 90.
Right.
Or per week, if you have decided 3, then 3 into 4, 12. Out of these 12, choose another 3, which will be the important news of the month.
Right, sir.
Right? So, if you are seriously doing like this, it will really help you. Prepare. And I made my students do this.
Right, sir. So right. The editorial section of a newspaper, how good is that?
That is very time consuming. Only some important editorials you can refer to. Not all of them are relevant. Very, very few of them, maybe once a week. Some good, like the moment this China thing happened. So initially some 1 or 2 editorials were good. See, editorials are opinions.
Right.
Most
sir.
Of the time, now the page also is being called as opinion page. Right. So they'll give the problem and then they'll say these are the suggested solutions. In fact, I've also written one or two articles have come in the editorial page.
Right, sir. I had seen that.
And you give opinions there and recommendations. Okay. So that is sometimes useful on important issues, like if there's a Galwan issue going on, read 1 hour. And the third last part is you can keep cutting also. If you have physical newspapers, if you're taking, you can keep cutting. But now I don't think anybody's taking physical newspapers.
Right, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Anybody has any questions?
Sir, I have a question, sir.
Yeah. Dalai.
Sir, during any G2 task, how should we avoid presence?
How should we avoid? Fight.
During any G2 task, how should we avoid pressure, sir?
Pressure, it is all in your mind. No, that's what sir also told. Be bold. Right, be bold. Don't keep pressure unnecessarily. Be original, be bold. And in GTO, I think the essence is to come ahead. Don't stay just behind. That's it. You come ahead, you will be in the forward zone in your group. And you will be able to think of some workable ideas. That's very important. Yeah. Anybody else, any questions? Right.
How to express?
How to express, Sandeep? Who's asking? Anuj is asking. Sandeep is asking.
Good afternoon, sir.
I am, sir. Tell me.
Yeah, good afternoon.
Tell me about yourself. Tell me about yourself. How can we express?
Tell me about yourself. So you have to think what I'm going to talk about myself. What are my good things? When you talk about yourself, you only talk of good things, no? You will not say that, sir, I'm a very bad person. You will only say, sir, I'm a very good, nice person. I've studied here. I've done this and this and this. And these are my background. These are my achievements. So talk good things about you. When somebody asks about you, tell them about good things, what you've done. Because you are going there to sell yourself to them. You have to sell yourself. You have to project your best part. Right? Sometimes they will corner you because they want to extract some negativities also. They'll ask you twisted questions. So sometimes you will have to come out with the truth about negativity. Suppose you failed 1 year, then you can't hide it. It's there on the report card. It's there in the PIQ. You have to justify it. Right? So keep that in mind. That you initially you tell good things about yourself, but then if there are setbacks, have correct justifications to give. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, Anuj, you wanted to ask something?
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I wanted to ask that, sir. I only do running and cycling. Are these two sports enough for mentioning in the PIQ?
No. Running and cycling is not a sport. Have you done athletics is a sports. If you've done competitive running, that means you've taken part in 100 meters.
I've done a lot of competitive running.
Yeah. So, fine. Then you can mention athletics is a sport. Not you can't say running. So mention athletics. But I'll also in the same breath also tell you that look, we also look at a student who has done some team games.
Yes, sir.
Right. We also team games have very important part, because leadership skills come out in team games.
Okay, so
100-meter sprint runner is not a leader. It's an individual,
sir.
Individual excellence. Team games make you a leader.
So, sir, is it important to just play one, at least one team game?
Ah, must play one team game. Good.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir, for clearing
that. Tomorrow, directly, we are finishing in the next 5-7 minutes. Anybody's got questions, just come on the screen, put your videos and ask.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes, Devashish.
How do we perform well in PPTD and GTO of PPTD and GTO tasks, sir?
Have you appeared in SSB before?
Yes, sir.
How many times?
So 3 times, sir. Screen out.
Which entry?
SSC Tech and INET entry, sir.
Yeah. What do you feel is your weakness? Why are you getting screened out? You have seen others also there who are performing. Where do you think you could not do well? Self analysis to karna padega na. Otherwise, how will you know yourself? How will you develop?
But tell you what I'm having problem in GD, sir. Sir, I'm unable to participate much more times.
Why you are unable to participate?
Actually, others are not letting me to speak.
No, they will let you speak. Everybody is there. Those who are qualified also. So don't blame others for your debacles. ये blameless attitude नहीं रखना है, attitude positive रखना है. अब कई बच्चे बोलते हैं number क्यों कम है सर, school में teacher पढ़ाते ही नहीं थे. और कोई रीजन बताओ सर, मम्मी पापा ने अच्छे स्कूल में नहीं भेजा. सारी दुनिया को ब्लेम नहीं करना, अपने आप को बोलो तुम्हारे में कुछ कमी थी, क्योंकि कोई तो सिलेक्ट हुआ ना. आप अगर आइडेंटिफाई नहीं, आप मतलब आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग देवाशीष, किसी को भी अगर आप आइडेंटिफाई नहीं कर पाओगे अपनी कमी, आप कभी जिंदगी में इंप्रूव नहीं कर पाओगे. जो मेरे को आगे फोन करके बोलते हैं सर मैंने सब ठीक किया, पता नहीं मैं क्यों फेल हो गया, मैं यकीन हो जाता है कि अगली बार भी फेल होगा. जो मेरे को फोन करता है सर मैं यहाँ गलती हो गया, मैं इसलिए इस बार फेल हो गया, या मेरा स्टोरी नहीं लिख पाया, या मैं बोल नहीं पा रहा था, एक्सप्रेस नहीं कर पाता हूँ, घबराता हूँ बोलने से सबके सामने, कम्युनिकेशन स्किल वीक है, आई से यस यू हैव कॉट योर प्रॉब्लम, नाउ प्लीज वर्क ऑन इट एंड डेवलप इट सेल्फ. आई हैव गॉट रिजेक्टेड बिकॉज अदर्स डिड नॉट लेट मी पार्टिसिपेट इज नो रीजन देवाशीष. आई एम गेटिंग माय पॉइंट. You have to realize where did I lack. So it could be probably because of lack of spontaneity in speaking. It could be a communication skill coming your way that you could not be as expressive. You could not, the moment you say I could not participate in GDUs, ke do hi karan ho sakte hai, ya to knowledge zero hai ya communication skill zero.